So you confirm. Yes, and you also confirm that during the ambush of former Brigadier General Barayogay, he was then the Chief of Police. Do you have records on that?
I do not have any information to that incident, sir. Oh, can
you furnish this committee?
Yes, Mr. Chair, sir.
The data when that ambush happened?
Yes, Mr. Chair, sir. We will do.
Okay. Since, Mr. Chairman, since Colonel Grijaldo is not around, maybe we can ask him on the next hearing. But before I proceed to my next question, Ma'am Garma, during the ambush of former General Barayoga, which is class 83, di ba? Class 83 siya?
I'm not sure, Your Honor.
Ayan ka na naman.
Hindi ko lang, maybe...
Secretary?
Yes, Your Honor. He is our board secretary.
So you don't know? Namatay niya yung corporate secretary mo? You don't even know that he's class 83? Simpleng tanong lang po. That was in the news. Alam ko eh. Bakit nag-evade ka? Simple question. Again, I warn you. I might cite you in contempt. Oh, do you confirm na he's a class 83? Classmate? Oh, okay, ito na lang.
A classmate of our chairman. So, yeah, whatever is the class of... Sir Pinili, I cannot,
classmate
I'm not
Sir
sure,
Pinili,
but classmate
of the former DLG secretary. Tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Ako, pagbibigyan kita, ma'am, yung sinasabi ko, diretso na ang pagkasagot.
Yes, Your Honor.
Kasi ang dami, pinapakinggan ko na kanina yung mga tanong. Ako nagtanong sa iyo kanina, pinakontempt na kita. Because usually your answer is, maybe. Maybe yes, maybe not. Simple question. Mamaya, pupuntahan kita dyan. Okay, anyway. Now, so you confirm that tatlo kayo pumunta kay Jimmy Portalesa. Because Jimmy Portalesa is your classmate.
Yes, Your
okay.
Honor.
Now, but of course, you deny that you talked to Jimmy Portalesa in his affidavit na you talked to him and asked him about the operations. Pero you never tell him the time based on in my personal and the affidavit of Jimmy Portalesa. You never told Jimmy Portalesa na may papatayin. You only told him na may operations. And pag sinabi mong operations, pag sa police, marami yan. Pwedeng may mamatay, pwedeng bypass, pwedeng dahil Bucor facility yun, pwede rin galugad. Diba? Diba?
Yes, Your Honor.
Tama. Okay. Now, akala ko maybe naman. Anyway. Now, and also, Jimmy Portalesa, in his affidavit, narrated na tumawag ka sa kanya. But of course, you deny it. That's why we are forced to order the NTC to submit. No? All the post, kasi kung prepaid, medyo mahirap. Unless otherwise, we still have your number sa prepaid. Can you tell us your number sa prepaid during the time?
I cannot recall anymore, Your
okay,
Honor.
Of course, you cannot recall. Diba? Pero ako, tandaan ko. Yung isang telepono ko, naiwan ko dun sa labas. Hindi ko na nabalikan, pero matandaan ko pa rin yung number ko. Pati yung company, Smart. Anyway, sige. Now, when the incident happened, that was August 11. Tama? Yung sa The Picol, August 11?
Yeah.
August 11 ba? Alright, ma'am. Anyway.
No, Your Honor.
Oh, tinitingnan mo lang yung... Kanino bang dokumentong tinitingnan mo? Affidavit of whom?
This was Leopoldo Tan, Your Honor.
Sorry?
Leopoldo Tan.
Oh, how did you...
It was published, Your Honor, in the website.
It was published, so you printed out?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Okay. Now, it was August 13. August 13 po. Okay, August 13. Now, it is a publicly knowledge incident because three Chinese national allegedly to be drug lords was killed inside the Picol. Now, question. You visited Jimmy Portelesa malapit lang po yung time nung pag-visit mo, no? Matter of weeks. Now, after that, did you call Jimmy Portelesa?
No, Your Honor.
Why?
Wala naman ako sasabihin sa kanya, Your Honor.
Sorry?
I have no purpose of calling him. Wala din ako number sa kanya. So, bakit ko siya tatawagan?
So, you do... Okay, sige. I will rephrase my question. You don't visit Jimmy Portelesa after that incident?
So, wala. Wala na po, Your Honor.
Oh, you don't bother to ask Jimmy Portelesa what really happened inside the Picol? You're an intelligence officer. You're very close to the president. Nangyari yung patayan doon. Same is true with Colonel Grijaldo, Colonel Leonardo that time. That time because you are the CIDG. You didn't even bother to visit the Picol. You, especially you, Ma'am Garma. You're the classmate of Jimmy Portelesa. You visit Jimmy Portelesa before the incident. Now, it happens. Sabi mo, wala akong nalalaman sa pangyari, but you didn't even bother to ask Jimmy Portelesa what really happened.
Wala akong number sa kanya, Mr. Chair.
Hindi nga. Wala kang number.
How can I call? How can I ask?
Oh, but some of your classmates has a number of Jimmy Portelesa.
I don't know, Mr. Chair.
Oh, you don't know na naman. Pero ang sinasabi ko lang, you don't even bother to visit Jimmy Portelesa after the incident to check what really happens inside that colony.
No, Mr. Chair.
Oh, kaya nga eh. Ayun nga ang sinasabi ko eh. Na nagbisita kayo, may nangyari, after that, you didn't even bother. That time, President Duterte has already assumed office. We will go that in that direction mamaya. Maybe Chairman Ako will discuss to you about it. Now, next. Eto, malapit-lapit tayo, Mamas. Please, sabihin mo lang po ang totoo. Okay, now. Sabi mo kanina, January 16, you start schooling, tama? Nag-schooling ka?
January 2016, yes, Your
Honor. Yeah, January 2016. So, safe ka. Kasing nangyari, August, because, ano yun, OSEC?
Yes.
For full colonel.
Yes, Your Honor.
When, kailan ka na-promote as full colonel?
2018, Your Honor.
2018?
16, yeah, 18, Your Honor.
Sigurado ka?
Hindi yes, Your Honor, 2018.
Sigurado ka?
Yes,
2018 of?
I think June, Your Honor.
O parang?
June.
Eto.
It's June ma'am. Of 2018, Your Honor.
Oh, ma'am, kasi yung mga ganyan after. Sa pulis, ako hindi ako pulis, pero as far as I know, pagdating doon sa colonel na posisyon hanggang general, hindi malilimutan ng general o colonel na napromote siya this year and this month. Well, in fact, even the date. Because that is an important promotion for each and every career officers in the PNP. Kasi pasikip na kayo, di ba? Tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh. Kasi mangilan-ngilan lang na yung mga light colonel ay sasampa na mabilis. Just like you. You're one of those privileged na na-promote 2018 pa lang as full colonel.
Huh?
On your class, ilan ba kayong full colonel during the time? Hindi mo matanda na naman. Of course, pwede ko bibigayan. PNP, please submit. Jen? Si General? No. Yung sa DIDM po, pakisubmit po yung ano, yung promotion of all class 97 from light colonel to full colonel po. Yung date and year.
Yes or no, Your Honor.
Please.
We will comply.
Please submit it before the next hearing.
Yes,
Your Honor. Maybe mabilis lang naman yan. Siguro within the week. I don't know. Okay, I will give you until Monday. But at Tuesday na po, Tuesday. At Tuesday.
Yes, Your
Honor. Okay? Before the hearing. Now, Ma'am Garama, so you're, after your schooling, you were assigned in Cebu. Tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Prior to your assignment in Cebu, you were assigned in Davao.
Yes, Your
As
Honor.
As what?
Station Commander, Your Honor.
Of?
Station 1, Santa Ana Police Station.
Station 1?
Yes,
okay.
Your Honor.
With the rank of Light Colonel?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Sa posisyon na yun, di ba pwedeng major doon?
Pwede rin po ang major, Your Honor.
Di ba? Tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. Now, yung position mo is only Light Colonel. You were assigned in Cebu. And as far as I know, no, but of course, I can't be wrong, I might be wrong, pero pag or highly urbanized city, not a component city, not a component city, rank of full colonel dapat, di ba? In the case of Cebu City, dapat full colonel.
Yes,
tama?
Yes, Your Honor.
Now, you're just a light colonel the time.
No, Your Honor.
Full pag-assign
colonel,
sa'yo?
Cebu City Police, Your Honor, I am full colonel. Full colonel.
Kailan kayo na-assign doon?
June yun po. June or July.
June of?
Basta I am already, na-promote na po ako.
Na-promote ka na?
Yes, Your Honor.
But OIC lang status mo doon?
It has to be confirmed by the mayor, Your Honor.
Ayun. Because the mayor does not want you to be the chief of police because prior to that, you were also assigned in Cebu, di ba?
Yes, Your Honor.
As what?
CIDG.
CIDG?
Regional Chief of Region 7.
Correct. Kaya kilala ka ni Mayor Osmeña.
Yes, Your
Kaya
Honor.
Kaya ayaw niya. Kasi kung kilala ka ni Mayor Osmeña because the regional center of Region 7 is Cebu. The regional office of CIDG is Cebu. Most of the activity of CIDG is in Cebu. And as the mayor that time of Cebu, kilala ka ni Mayor Osmeña. That is why ayaw niya sa'yo. Because on your record during the time, napakarami pong nangyari during the time. And we are now collating all those incident, no, related to death nung time na yon as CIDG Region 7 at the same time Chief of Police of Cebu. Now, Chief of the CIDG ka the time?
Yes, Your Honor.
Yung rank mo is Light Colonel?
Yes, Your Honor.
During the time, Regional Director can be a Light Colonel ng CIDG?
It can be, Your Honor.
It can be.
Yes,
except
Your Honor.
Except for, sabi ko nga, highly urbanized city. Diba? Just like Cebu City. Dapat full colonel.
Yes, Your
Tama.
Honor.
Now, anyway, let me proceed with, bago pumunta doon, balikan mo mamaya, your travel records. I have with me your travel records.
Yes, Your Honor.
Okay. I have with me since, from 2024 to 2012. Okay? Ma'am Garma, you're most traveled, though you're not anymore in public office.
Yes, Your Honor.
Tama. Who's older you traveled?
Somewhere sponsored by my cousins when I traveled.
Cousins? Who are your cousins?
I was invited for
Who are your cousins? Who are your cousins?
Anne-Marie Batay.
From where?
United States.
Okay, US.
Yes, Your Honor.
Then, siya lang? Nagsisponsor sa'yo?
Hindi pa po. Meron pa Hazel Idnay.
But, yeah, Comsec, please take note of all the names that are being mentioned by Ms. Garma. Yes, please proceed. Who else?
Yun lang po ang nagtumulong
so,
po.
So, dalawa lang?
Yes, because I was invited to an occasion.
In the US. But how about your travel in Asia? Who sponsored it?
I paid for it.
You paid for it?
Honor. Yes.
Tingnan mo, Mama. Your travel for just 2024, you traveled 6 times abroad.
Wow!
Just in 2024. Tapos, yung travel mo 2023 is 13 times. You traveled 13 times abroad.
Wow!
13 times. This is a record coming from the Bureau of Immigration, Madam, you cannot deny this. Iba't ibang lugar, may Kuala Lumpur, may ano. In the next hearing, tatanungin pa kita po para at least papaunahan kita. Pero sa ngayon, ang tanong ko lang po, who sponsored you? How can you afford to travel 13 times in just one year? You're not anymore an official of the government. This is an official travel. Oh, where did you get? Where did you get? Ma'am? Oh, you want to an executive session?
No, Your Honor.
No? Also, answer me. All the SSI in contempt.
I paid for it, Your Honor.
Yeah, you paid for it. How much is your, ano? How much is your, can you provide us? Are you willing to have a waiver for your bank accounts?
No, Your Honor.
No. Why? Because you're not telling the truth. You are hiding something. Ito, inisyal pa lang, Mama. Oh. You travel 13 times? Ibig sabihin on more than every month you travel outside in the country. Now, last question ko, Ma'am. What is, eto Mama, diretso kita, what is your latest travel abroad? When was that? When was that?
Japan, Your Honor.
Japan? Hindi, your purpose of your travel.
USA, Your Honor.
Oh, USA. Now, pakiano lang, what happened with the travel?
Okay, I have to travel to USA to
bring, why?
To bring my daughter in the US.
Why?
Because of this exposure.
When was that? When was that? When was that?
September, August, Mr. Chair.
Eh, daming August, 30 days yung August.
28.
Ah, hindi, ganito lang po, ma'am.
28.
Diretsuhin kita. Oh.
28.
Your plan to travel in the US was August 28. That was the time that the squad ko was already started, di ba? The investigation.
Yes, Your Honor.
And your name was already crop up.
Yes,
tama?
Your Honor.
Oh. Now, in short, you're using that alibi to bring your daughter to the U.S. to evade this investigation.
No, Your Honor.
No, okay. Why did... Anong nangyari? Ba't hindi ka naka-U.S.? Ba't nandito ka ngayon?
My visa, U.S. visa was canceled.
Why?
Hindi po sinabi sa akin ang reason why.
Hindi sinabi? You never asked?
I asked, but Japan in charge on the desk did not tell me the reason.
No, kasi papasok ka sa US, di ba? Kasi kung hindi ka tinanggap ng Japan, that is the responsibility of Japan. But you were not allowed, di ba, to go to US because what?
It was not explained to me by the in charge sa Japan po. Kasi ang nung mag-check in po kami,
check in for going to
ticket, kukuha po ng ticket Japan to US.
I know
US,
you yeah. Don't have a ticket yet.
Yes, Your Honor. Oh,
kaya nga eh. Kaya you want to travel to the US but you don't have a ticket.
No,
iba, inamin mo na eh.
No, Your Honor, ang ticket namin is all connecting. Nung magbo-board po ako para if I mag-check in kami for the seat, I wasn't able to get a seat kasi nag-e-error na yung system.
Sandali.
So we sought the
balikan ko muna.
Yes po.
So yung travel mo is from the Philippines connecting Japan to
Japan.
US.
Yes, Your Honor.
You have a ticket, Philippines, Japan, US.
Yes, Your Honor.
Are you sure of that?
Ang binigay po ng...
Sandali! Ito naman kita. Simple na to, ma'am. Do not evade my question.
Okay, yes, Your Honor.
Your ticket is, as you have said, your ticket is Philippines, Japan, US.
Yes, Your Honor.
Oh, but you were not allowed. Yun na, may ticket ka. Sigurado ka, Philippines, Japan, US.
Ang ticket po namin is Philippines, Japan.
Kaya nga,
Your Honor.
Huwag mo nga akong lituhin, ma'am. Ang tinatanong ko, malapit ka na, ma'am. Ang tinatanong ko kanina, yung ticket mo is only Philippine, Japan. Sabi mo hindi. Philippine, Japan, US. You get a ticket in Japan for US.
Boarding pass po yung kukunin na namin sa Japan. Hindi po ako nakakuha. anyway, Your Honor.
Do you have a copy of that?
Wala na po, Your Honor.
Oh, BID, DFA. Anong airlines? Oh, hindi mo na naman masagot. Simpleng-simple yan. It happens last 2 weeks ago. Sige nga. Kasi you're lying, ma'am.
No, Mr. Chef.
You are lying. Okay. Now, question. Your ticket. Anong airplane? Oh, you cannot answer? Simple. Something happens in Japan. No, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, hindi rin ito makalusot eh. Kasi pag tinawag kong DFA, alam ng DFA.
Japan, I think it's Japan Airline, that's why we landed.
Why I think na naman? Kanina, maybe. Now, I think.
It is Japan Airline, Mr. Chair.
From the Philippines.
I'm very sure of it na. I can recall it, Japan Airline.
From the Philippines.
To Japan.
To Japan. Then, what airlines supposedly to the U.S.?
It's the same. It's Japan Airlines.
Japan Airlines. Oh, ngayon nga. Dalawa na. Twice na. Last ko na mamaya na tanong. Anyway, Mr. Chairman, I move that we... Dahil walang kopya daw, wala nang records, walang documents from Ms. Garma. Mr. Chairman, can we ask for the documents, travel documents, with regards to the plane that was booked by Ms. Garma from the Philippines, Japan, and to the U.S.?
We will ask the records from the DFA?
Yeah, from the DFA po. Okay. Tsaka BID na. Tsaka Japan Airlines.
Okay, ComSec, kindly coordinate with the Bureau of Immigration and our DFA as to the travel records of Colonel Ruyina Garma.
Wala. Wala bang DFA dito? And also, Mr. Chairman, can we ask the DFA the reason why Ms. Garma was not permitted to travel to have an entry from Japan to the U.S.?
ComSec, you are so directed.
Para official lang po. Kasi alam din na yun ni Ms. Garma eh, bakit hindi siya pinayagan. Alam mo, deep inside, you know why you were not allowed entry to the U.S.
I cannot just say what's deep inside, Mr. Chair, because I'm not sure.
Yeah, that's your alibi, that's your defense. Yes, that's your defense, ma'am. Okay.
Mr. Chair.
Congressman Akop, with the indulgence of Congressman Paduano.
Before we leave that issue in Japan, may be permitted to ask some questions?
With the indulgence of Congressman Paduano.
Yes, Mr. Chairman.
Please proceed, Congressman Akop. Representation.
Madam Garma, nung bumili ka ng ticket,
yes.
Saan bang intention mo na pupuntahan talaga?
Mr. Chair? I didn't get the question.
Ano ang intention mo talaga nung bumili ka ng ticket? Japan or US?
US, okay. US, Mr. Chair.
Eh bakit hindi ka kumuha ng buong ticket diretsong papuntang US? Why do you have to procure a ticket doon sa Japan?
No, Mr. Chair, I did not procure a ticket sa Japan. I procured the ticket already.
So, stopover mo lang.
Stopover lang po ang Japan.
And yes. You were not allowed to board papuntang US.
Kasi po,
ganun ba yun na nangyari?
Yes, Mr. Chair. But hindi ako makakuha ng boarding,
Boarding pass?
Yes, Mr.
Kasi
Chair.
Kasi yun naman ang kailangan mo eh.
Yes.
Di ba?
Yes, Mr.
Kasi
Chair.
Kasi may schedule na flight papuntang US. Nakasakay ka ron. Stopover sa Japan.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
How many hours?
10 hours, Mr. Chair.
10 hours?
Yes po.
So, nung magbo-board ka ng Japan Airlines for the US, hindi ka na pinapasok.
Yes, Mr.
Ganun
Chair.
Ganun na nangyari?
Opo, Mr. Chair.
That is the reason why, according to records, 29 August, nakabalik ka na dito sa Pilipinas.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Thank you.
Wow!
Mr. Chair.
Mr. Chairman, can I interject?
With the indulgence of Congressman Paduano, the Senior Deputy Speaker is recognized.
Talong ko lang to kay Ma'am Garma. Ma'am, di ba, pag pumupunta tayo ng U.S., from the Philippines, kicheck na yung US visa mo dito sa Pilipinas. Pag board mo lang sa airport, bibigyan ka ng boarding pass. Boarding pass from the Philippines to Japan, Japan to Philippines.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Tama po ba?
Yes po.
So, yun po yung tanong. Bakit binigyan kayo ng boarding pass na hindi na-check yung US visa? Hindi po kayo bibigyan ng boarding pass kung hindi po i-check yung US visa.
Yes, Mr.
Normal po, routine po yun pag nagpupunta tayo Amerika. Yeah, tama po ba?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Very unusual nung araw pong yun, Mr. Chair.
So, yun po siguro ang tanong ni Chairman Acop, di ba? Salamat po, Mr. Chairman.
Congressman Paduano, please proceed.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Anyway, Mr. Chairman, hearing the answers of Colonel Garma, Ms. Garma kanina, with regards to question of deployment, na napaka-juicy yung mga position from DIA, from tsaka puro lahat Dabaw, ang assignment except sa Cebu. Tapos nag-schooling, tapos early retirement. Again, can you state when was your the date or the year that you retired?
That's June of 2019, Your
Honor. June of 2019. When did you assume as PCCO chairman?
July 15 of 2019, Your Honor.
Oh, 1 month lang. Di ba? Tama? 1 month?
15 days, I think, Your Honor.
Oh, 15 days pa. Sobra. Yeah! Now, during the interpellation, Mr. Chairman, ng mga members kanina, Ma'am Garma, Ms. Garma, keep on denying that he's close to the former president. Di ba? Kasi sabi mo lang lagi, maybe. Binigyan ka ng posisyon, tingnan mo. Woo! You check the record. 10 years pa yung supposedly before you retire, 10 years ka pa, but you opt to early retirement. Tapos, wala pang man-man, sabi mo nga, 15 days, bigla ka nag-PCSO. Tapos, itong tinanong ka kanya, sabi mo, are you close to the president, former president? Ang sagot mo, because of those promotions, sabi mo, is maybe, maybe, not maybe. Now, I will ask you, are you special and close to the president, former president? Yes or no lang po? Walang personal? Yes or no lang po? Kasi lahat-lahat eh. Oh, why can't you answer? Simple lang tanong ko. Are you close to the former president? Because that's why you've been given a juicy position when in fact, 1 month, wala pa nga, 15 days ka lang nag-retire, na PCSO chairman ka na kagad. Sige nga, yes or no, why can't you answer? Oh, Mr. Chairman, since
because, Mr. Chair.
Oh, why? What?
I do not. No, Mr. Chair.
Oh, sige nga.
Because you said, am I close or special to the president?
Yeah, you're close to the president. Or special. Kasi, tanungin mo yung lahat mga classmates mo. Ako, mama, mga classmates mo, ikaw ang tumulong for their promotion during the time of President Duterte. That's why I'm asking the DIDM to submit to this committee all the years of promotion of all your classmates. Now, ang question ko ngayon, diretso na. I hope you will answer truthfully. Are you close to the president?
Mr. Chair, I'm not close. I was fired.
Okay. Okay.
Nag-floating pa nga po ako during his time.
Huwag mo, anong ma-floating during your his time?
Yes, Mr. Chair,
15 days lang na nag-retire ka, nag-PCSO chairman ka, for all those qualified applicants. Okay. Ang dami po. Na-qualify. Why you? And though, the fact is, Mayor Osmeña is keep on insisting, kaya nag-OIC ka lang, kasi he never choose you in the list. Tama? O na, ang question ko, are you close and special to the president?
For me, Mr. Chair, I don't feel close and special.
Okay, now, Mr. you're lying.
Chair, because...
You're lying, ma'am.
Can I explain, Mr. Chair?
Of course, explain.
You know, there was once in my career na siyang mayor, nag-floating po ako 6 months, I don't have any position.
Ma'am, when was that?
That was in 2011.
No, that
Mr.
was
Chair,
way back. Way back, ma'am.
Floating po ako.
But before he became president of this republic, you're very close to the president. Before your assignment in Cebu, you're very close to the president. Before you retire, you're very close to the former president.
Wow.
And now you're talking to this committee? You're telling us that you're not close to the president? That's only a simple question. Now, you deny. You said no. You said no. Oh, Mr. Chairman.
Can I, Mr. Chair?
Balik lang tayo. Yeah. Okay, given you were floated. Yeah.
Kasi,
2011.
Yes, Mr.
Oh, but after that, lahat na position mo, juicy. You can never stay. Palipat-lipat ka doon sa Davao and you will not be deployed as CIDG in Region 7. You cannot be deployed even the opposition of the mayor that time, Mayor Espeña, if you're not close to the president. You're telling me that it's the chief PNP? Now, kung chief PNP, bakit nung nag-retire ka 15 days after bisita o chairman ka? If you're not chosen, if you're not close, if you're not special to the president. Oh. Oh, why you're not answering?
Perhaps, Mr. Chair, I am special.
Perhaps ka na naman. Anyway, Mr. Chairman, ito, but I move to cite in contempt because the resource person is evading to answer questions being asked by almost all members. Paulit-ulit lang yung perhaps mo. Maybe. Ngayon, perhaps na naman. Move to cite you in contempt, Mr. Chairman.
Mr. Chair.
If I may, honorable members, I will just allow the chair first to make a clarification on the motion of Congressman Paduano. Congressman Paduano, is that a motion?
Yes, that's a motion. So, I move to cite in contempt. Sandali lang po, co-chair. Abante, give me the time because this is my time.
Okay. I
move to cite in contempt Ms. Garma for lying and evading questions being asked by the members of this committee.
Before that, is that an
amendment to the motion?
No, perhaps, please listen to my questions first before we act on the motion of my co-chair who is angry now.
Yes. Okay. Will Congressman Abante propound questions to Colonel Garma?
I think we have a pending motion, Mr. Chairman.
I am just
we just have to follow the rules first.
Mr. Chairman, just to clarify, the violation of Ms. Garma is refusal to answer.
Hearing is suspended.
Suspended tayo mga kasama. Please, respect the decision of the chairman, please.
Hearing is resumed.
Thank you. Can I be allowed to speak, Mr. Chairman, to reiterate my motion?
Go ahead, Congressman Paduano.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Again, Mr. Chairman, I move to cite in contempt Ms. Garma for in violation of our rules, letter C of our internal rules and contempt for refusal to answer relevant questions, Mr. Chairman. So move.
Second motion.
There is a motion to cite in contempt Rowena Garma for violating Section 11, Paragraph C of the rules. Rules of procedure governing inquiries in aid of legislation. Any second?
Second motion.
I object. Second.
Any second?
Second motion, Mr. Chairman.
Duly seconded. Are there any objections?
I object.
May I know what is the objection of our Congressman?
I still have some questions to ask Colonel Garma. In relation to what my good friend who is always angry to her these questions.
Alam mo na, pare.
Okay.
Chairman, I move to strike out the antonary statement of the my co-chair Abante.
I second.
Mr. Chairman, 1 minute suspension, please.
Okay.
Hearing is assumed. The parliamentary status is that Congressman Paduano moved for the to cite Ruina Garma in contempt for violating Section 11, Paragraph C of our Rules of Procedure governing inquiries in aid of legislation. And it was duly seconded. When the chair asked if there are any objections, there was an objection raised by Congressman Abante. And the chair asked Congressman Abante what his objections were. And there was a short exchange of statements coming from Congressman Abante and Congressman Paduano, until the chair moved for a suspension for 1 minute. Now we resume our hearing, and may I know what is the pleasure of Congressman Abante?
Well, Mr. Chair, upon the upon our discussion, I will withdraw my objection to the motion, Mr. Chair. But I would like to ask questions.
Yes, you may do so, Congressman Abante. The motion was withdrawn. Let us now proceed to vote on the motion to cite Ruina Garma in contempt. So again, it was duly seconded. Are there any objections? Hearing none, the motion is carried. Congressman Paduano, what is the next motion?
Mr. Chairman, I yield to Congressman Congressman Rhodes Rodriguez for the second motion. Do you want to move for a second motion? Yeah.
Mr. Chair, in relation to the motion passed for the contempt of Colonel Garma, I move that she be held in the House facility until the
Termination of the hearing.
Until the committee report is passed.
Mr. Chairman, I have the information that the facility that we have in here right now is full of all those resource persons who have been cited in contempt. Thereby, we cannot accommodate anymore the presence of the resource person in the personality of GM Garma. Thereby, we amend our motion to put the resource person Daluyong in the correctional facility. Mr. Chairman.
So instead of detaining Ruina Garma, GM Garma, in the facilities of the House of Representatives, we will then detain her to
Women's Correctional
in the city of Mandaluyong.
Mr. Chair, I submit to the
Your Honor, please. May we,
Mr. Lawyer?
No, I'm sorry.
You're not allowed.
Yes, you are not
under
allowed.
Our rules.
So
you talk to your client.
She will be detained at the Mandaluyong Women's Correctional Center, correct?
Yes. Mr. Chair, I'll be amending my motion.
Please.
Given the wisdom of the Chair Dan Fernandez, I therefore move that we, in line with the contempt order you just issued, I move that we detain Colonel Garma in the Mandaluyong Women's Correctional Facility, and the period will be until the termination of this hearing.
Again. There is a motion, so stated, duly seconded. Are there any objections?
Mr. Chair?
Is that an objection, Colonel Busita?
Yes, Mr. Chair. Being a retired police commission officer, and pwede po ba na siya ay sa ano na lamang po ma-detain sa PNP custodial? Mr. Chair?
1 minute suspension. Mm-hmm.
Mr. Chairman.
Let me just state for the record the parliamentary status. There is a pending motion on the second motion wherein there was a discussion as to where we will detain GM Rowena Garma, whether in the premises of the House of Representatives or outside of the premises of the House of Representatives. And there was a motion made by Congressman Gutierrez stating that she will be detained at the Women's Correctional Center in Mandaluyong. We'd like to...
Mr. Chair.
To is that in yes. relation to the motion?
Yes, because we have an information that we can now accommodate our resource person here in the premises of the of this House of Representatives. So thereby, we'll be requesting Congressman Gutierrez to amend his motion.
Yes, Mr. Chair, I'd like to move to amend my motion again, given the development that the LSB has imparted to us that the House facility can actually entertain another detainee. I therefore amend my motion, Mr. Chair, and I'd like to move instead that in relation to the contempt order of Colonel Garma, that she be detained in the House detention facility, and the term to be determined is that until the termination of the hearings at the QuadCon.
Okay, there is a motion.
Second motion.
The first motion is to detain her in the premises of the House of Representatives. And another motion is for how many days, Congressman Gutierrez?
Mr. Chair, until the termination of the hearings at the QuadCon.
So she will be detained until the termination of the QuadCon in all its hearings.
Okay, Mr. Chair.
Congressman Akop.
Supposing the hearing is not still terminated and she will tell the truth, what is the... Can she be released from detention?
Certainly, Congressman Akop, the violation she has committed is in violation of Section 11, Paragraph C, wherein she refuses to answer and cooperate, and she tries to evade answering the questions propounded by the members. So if she changes her mind and she suddenly cooperates, then the committee will be more than willing to accommodate her motion for reconsideration. Is that all right? Does that satisfy Congressman Akop? Thank you. So the motion to detain GM Garma in the premises of the House of Representatives until we terminate the hearing on by the QuadCom. Duly seconded. Any second?
Second, Mr. Chair. Second.
Duly
Mr.
seconded. Chair. Any objection? Hearing none, the motion is approved. Comsec, please coordinate with the Sergeant at Arms. Ooh.